Hello, this is Abbebe from University of Gondor Faculty of Informatics, and then this is our sub-tutorial on the programming course, Fundamentals of Programming with C++. On our previous tutorial, we have seen about the different C++ statements in a program. So basically in C++, there are five types of statements: the declaration, initialization, input, output, and expression. So depending on the kind of program that we are going to write, or depending on the kind of problem that we are going to solve, we can use all or some of those statements. But one thing that you should keep in mind is that Cout statement is a must for all C++ program, but the rest of the three statements are optional, so we may include or not include those statements. The other very much important point that you should keep in mind is that those five statements must indeed use a semicolon as a syntax, whether it's declaration, initialization, input or output, or expression statement. Those all statements must indeed use a semicolon, otherwise we'll get a syntax error. So in today's class, we will see about the conditional or the control statement. So to understand what exactly this conditional statement, let's have a look at our previous program. So this is our previous program that will accept two numbers from the user and then display the sum of these two numbers. So if we see the order of execution, as you see here, this statement, the first statement will be executed first, the second statement will be executed second, and that. Have a look at this is the first statement, so it will be executed first. Second statement will be executed second, third, fourth, and so on and so forth. Meaning the execution of C++ program is sequential. The first statement which occurs first will be executed first, the second will be executed second, and then like that. The last will be executed last. So from this specific example, this statement will be executed first, this will be executed second, third, fourth, this way. And then finally, this is the last statement that will be executed. So the order of the C++ program execution is sequential. But the one thing that we need to understand is, what if we want to change this sequential execution from one way to another? In that case, there is a need to have this, what we call it, a control structure or loop statements. Okay, what if we want to jump from this to the other side of the program? In that case, there is a need to use the loop statement. For example, starting from here, I need to jump to directly to this program, this statement. Sometimes from here, I need to jump directly to this statement. In that case, there is a need to use what we call it conditional statement. Okay, so when conditional statement is used, that's very much important point. So to understand that thing, let's have a look at the flowchart example. So this is our first program that will accept two number and then display output to the user. When we come to here, we look at this program, it's totally different. We do have another new operator right here. Do you see this one? We do have a new diagram on our flowchart. So this is what we call it, condition. Okay, so depending on this condition, the program execution will change. For example, have a look, this is a flowchart that will check whether a given number is positive or not. So this is a condition that will let the compiler either to go this way, okay, either to go this way. Okay, see, depending on this condition, we can, if this condition is false, we let the compiler to go this way. If not, we let the compiler to go this way. So this is what we call it, condition. So depending on this condition, the order of execution will change. So this is what we call it, conditional statement. So I will look at the second example. So this is a flowchart that will check whether a given number is even or odd. So after you accept a number, we are going to check whether that number is even or odd. Meaning, if a number divided by 2, if the remainder is 0, that number is even, otherwise that number is odd. So basically, this modulo operator means the remainder. A number divided by 2, if the remainder is 0 meaning that number is even. So this way we are going to check whether a given number is even or odd. So by any means, if you have such kind of condition, we can let the compiler to move either this way or this way. So this is what we call it conditional statement. So basically in C++ there are two conditional statement. Okay, what we call it if else and switch case. So we are going to see each one by one. So let's start with the if else statement. So basically we use the if else statement if we have a condition to check. The same is true for if else. But let's have a look at some code example to check whether a given number is positive or negative. Okay, so let's see. Now I'm going to erase everything from the previous program, and here we are going to declare a number, and then we'll tell the user to input that number. Enter a number. Okay, enter a number, and then input statement that number, and then this is it. We just accept the number from the user. And then we have to check whether that number is positive or negative. So we are going to use the if statement. I will look if. So if is a statement in C++ to handle condition. For example, if the number is greater than 0, what to do next? We are just telling the compiler to check this condition first before executing the second statement. So depending on this condition, the execution either will directly go to the second statement or will jump to the other part of the program. If the value of num greater than 0, we need to display the output positive, for example. Otherwise, if not, otherwise means in C++ x for if x. Otherwise, display not positive. You see this one? So this is a condition, the if statement. If this condition is satisfied, the execution will go this way and then directly jump to the return 0. It will not execute the else statement. If this condition is false, it will directly go to the else statement. See, now the order of execution has been changed. It's not going to execute statement line by line. So it highly depending on this one. So if this statement is true, the execution will go this way. See? Otherwise, if this statement is false, the execution will go to this way. So we are just telling the compiler to jump from one statement into another, depending on the condition. So this is how you just handle condition in C++ with the help of the if statement. Okay? So depending on the if statement, either this or this will be executed. Let's see. Let's compile. Our program is error free. Let's run. When we run, hopefully enter num1 text will appear, the string. So just blinking means input the value of num1. 8 means positive. So 8 greater than 0, as output positive will appear on the screen. Enter. So positive. Let's run again. Enter a number, negative 9, and then the output will be negative 9, not positive will appear. But when we run the program, okay, let's run the program, 0, enter, it says not positive, but 0 is neither negative or positive. So in that case, we need to have another condition to handle. We need to check whether that number is positive, negative, or zero. Here we have only one condition. Depending on that condition, it will display either positive or negative. So this is the very simple program that will accept a number and then check whether that number is positive or negative. So here there is no more sequential execution. Not all statements will be executed. Only the statement which will satisfy the condition will be executed. If this is true, only this statement will be executed and then stop the execution. If this is false, only this will be executed and then the stop execution. So this is how we just control the execution order of the program. So this is our first program that will check whether a given number is positive or not. Let's modify this program so that it will display whether a given number is positive, negative, or zero. In that case, we need to have another condition to handle. So if means to check the condition, else means if the above condition is fail to execute, it failed to satisfy, and then if we have another condition, we can add another if next to the else. Num less than zero, if that is the case, negative will be executed. We have another condition, else if num comparison operators double equal sign equals to zero, and then finally we are going to display zero. Have a look. On our previous condition, we have only one condition, and now we just add more condition to handle more situations. Have a look. If the number is greater than zero, the word positive will appear. Else means if the previous condition failed to satisfy, and if this condition satisfy, will display negative. Else means if the above two conditions fail to satisfy, and then if this condition satisfy, we'll just display zero. Let's see. Okay, run 9 positive, fine. Run negative 8 negative, right. Last one is 0 0. That's right, it's going well. But one thing, possible way to write this kind of program is if a number is not positive or negative, obviously it's zero. So there is no need to specify this condition, it's optional. You can do it, you can incorporate the condition of zero, but if a number is not positive or negative, obviously it's zero. So it's optional to add this condition. Okay, this is how you just handle the conditions. So if you have such kind of condition in a flow chart, if you have such kind of condition in our previous flow chart, I think I've seen, yeah. In our previous flow chart, we have seen how we just deal with the condition. So if you have a condition, we can do it with the if else statement. So let's have another program then. So this is a program to check whether a given number is positive, negative, or zero. And then let's check, let's modify this program to check whether a given number is even or odd. In that case, we need to incorporate a condition. We need to check whether a given number modulo 2 is equal to zero. Meaning, if that number divided by 2, if the remainder, modulo means remainder, if the remainder is zero, meaning that number is even. For example, 4 divided by 2 is 2, we have the remainder of 0. In that case, 4 is even number. If we consider 5, 5 divided by 2 is 2, and then we have 1 as a remainder, which is different from 0. In that case, we have to display odd. So if a number modulo equals to 0, that number is obviously even. Even. Otherwise, display odd. So this is another program which check whether a given number is even or odd. So here we don't have any sequential execution. The execution will depending on this condition. If this is true, this statement will be executed. If not, this statement will be executed. Okay, let's check. Obviously, number 4 is an even number. Okay. 8 is an even number because 8 divided by 2 is 4. We don't have any extra number left. That's the 0 as a remainder. So in that case, 8 is also, even is output. And then the other one is, for example, 5. Okay. 5. Okay. 5. 5 is a given number. 5 divided by 2 is 2, but we do have 1 as a remainder, so 1 is not equal to 0. 1 equal to 0 is false, so the else statement will be executed, so we'll get odd as an output. So this is how we just handle if statements, how we just handle condition with if statements. Okay, so if you want to do some more example, you can do it with if statement. So this is how you just implement, just handle the condition with the help of if statement. So for example, we can modify this program to do some other operations. For example, let's see how we can just calculate grade display, for example, enter mark. Okay, for example, we can have this condition: if the mark greater than or equals 19, I need to give for a student of A, result A. So this is how you just calculate the mark of a given student. Otherwise, if the mark is not greater than 19, and if the mark is greater than, for example, 70, I need to give the value of A. So this is the value of B, sorry. Otherwise, and then if the mark is greater than or equals to 50, I need to give the C result. Otherwise, and if the mark greater than or equals to 30, I need to give for example D. If it is less than 30, otherwise, if it's less than 30, you can do it otherwise, and if the mark less than or equals to 29, hopefully the result will be F. So this is how you just calculate the grade of a student. But the last statement, as I told you before, the last statement, we can avoid the condition, because if the number is not greater than 90, 70, 50, or 30, obviously it's less than 29. It's an obvious condition, so we can erase the condition. So usually the last statement is the end statement. So you can keep it or you can avoid it, it's possible. So if you run and then if you provide, for example, 85, compile, run, enter mark D. Sorry, we just forgot to see. Do you see the problem? We just forgot to input the value of mark. That's why. So here, see in mark. So compile and run. So enter mark will appear on the screen. So this time we are going to provide the mark of a student, okay? For example, 85. 85 is not greater than 90, but it's greater than 70, so the output will be B. B. So this is how you just calculate the grade of a student. And then let's see the other program to check whether a given character is vowel or consonant. So for example, to do that, to store a character variable, we have to use a character data type and say x, and then say in enter a character, and then we will input x, and then we have to check the condition: if the value of x equals, so if it's a character, put it in a single quotation, a, we can use an or operator. See, if the value of x equals to a, or we are going to repeat this condition, because if the value of character x equals to a, e, I, or u, the output is vowel. So we are not going to have each condition with each and every else statement, because it will increase the number of code. So we can handle many conditions in a single if statement if they all have the same output. Okay, you see, A, E, and then I, and then O, then u. If the value of x is either of this option, they have the common output, which is vowel. Otherwise, if the value of x is different from the above five conditions, otherwise, else, we have to display consonant. Okay, this is a very simple program again, which accepts a character and then check whether that character is vowel or consonant. By the way, we can do this in each if statement. Okay, for example, you can do it this way. Else, let's execute first actually this one, compile. There's a problem, corrects, sorry, it's not seen, this is else, compile, run, see, run the program. We just, for example, a is vowel, so we'll get vowel as an output. Run. T is consonant, we just get consonant as an output. So this is one and the easiest way to handle whether a given character is vowel or consonant, because we just combine multiple conditions with or, because meaning either of these two conditions satisfied, vowel will be executed. So this is the short and effective way to handle such kind of condition. But if you don't use or, you will have lots of conditions. If you don't use or, you are expected to do this one. See, count vowel. Okay. Else if. See. So if you don't combine the condition with or, you are expected to do if for each and every condition. So that's not the best way. That will increase the number of code that will make your code not clear for other users. So is a one thing that you should keep in mind is that if you have condition with the same output, so you can combine those conditions with or operator. So this is how you check whether a given number is, or whether a given character is a vowel or consonant. So if is a conditional statement that will handle conditions, that will tell the compiler to go in a different part of the program based on the condition. If it's true, the statement next to the if statement will be executed. Otherwise, it will go to the else statement to check another condition. If we don't have another condition, the else statement will be executed. So this is what you need to know about the if else. So on our second tutorial, on our next tutorial, we are going to see the other conditional statement, what we call it a switch case, and then we will see, we will compare and contrast when to use if else and then when to use switch case. Thank you very much. Bye.